Hey, this is Arlene. It is September the 19th, and I'm going to go out and get some fresh air. So anyways, I got really, really burnt, and since I got really burnt, I need to cool off. See him leaving. That's 118. So anyways, so I got really burnt with my feet and stuff. And so that is a gang stalker in a car over there. And then that's 7-Eleven. And then there's one down that way. I think it looks like a Toyota SUV, maybe. Now all the business here is closed. So I'm not really sure what he would be doing in here. So you can see I'm pretty burnt. So I've been getting targeted a lot from derby tenants. These are some gang stalkers here. You can tell they're not here. They're not gonna spend the night. You can tell they came and they sat there because they're gang stalkers. Lots of people coming out now. So anyways, my cat stuff was taken out. Someone actually took my package. There's another gang stalker over in that area that just came out. A lot of them from the houses right in this area participate. There he is. So anyways, I'm walking south on Wilton, cooling off, and we're passing Sierra Vista, getting targeted from that Department of Water and Power light. This is Romaine right here. Two gang stalkers up. Let's see if they actually leave. Here's another one. So this gang stalker walked to the corner and then made a U-turn. doing the usual, going to 7-Eleven. That is from frequencies to the lungs. There he goes. Comes another one. So these gang stalkers sitting in the car actually pressed on the brake lights. So, anyways, this is Sierra Vista. This guy's been here before. I've encountered him before. So he's just standing in front of 5542. Watch, I'm gonna ask him if he's a gang stalker. Why not? I don't have anything to lose. So that's his bike, maybe. Excuse me. Are you a gang stalker? Yeah. Are you a gang stalker? Why would you just stop right here? Do you do neighborhood watch? This is his bike, so. We're in front of 5542. So are you a gang stalker? Do you live here at 5542? He patrols here. This is like the fourth time I've seen him here. If you look at some of my YouTube videos, he doesn't live at 5542. And then this is another one that followed me halfway down and then made a U-turn and went to 7-Eleven in the t-shirt right here. He's just walking around the block. I don't know if he lives at the Derby or he's just gonna be wandering around. Yeah, that guy. This is behind the south end of the Derby. that's new, the blue light for that apartment. And they're standing there. I should just wave to them. Because they're standing there looking out. What is it with the blue light? The blue light, the amber light, and the green light. They left, and they were illegally parked in the red. No ticket. Now we're going back on to Wilton. Later on I'll have to look. I'm going to look for my cat's litter box. I mean cat food. Someone took my delivery. That one drives up and down Santa Monica and Wilson. See, they left. I knew they were gang stalkers. I don't think that truck was there earlier. It's not as cold as I was hoping it would be. I think I'll probably cool off more if I just turn on my air conditioner. There's that truck still. No, it's an SUV. Still there. I want to say it's like a Jeep or something. This one just pulled up, never got out for 7-Eleven. So probably I'm thinking people are getting alerts and they're having to get out of the car, get in their cars. Who knows, maybe they have to jump out of bed. This is at 7-Eleven. See, all those other places are all closed. So they really shouldn't be up there. This one's regular too, the white truck. See how empty that parking lot is now? There's one at the end. By the church. There's one guy standing there. That's Gold Diggers. That's 5624 Santa Monica. A lot of gang stalkers in there. And most of these businesses do participate too. He must be neighborhood patrol. Goes. Okay, time to turn back. see how wavy? Right there. I'll be this smart ass. Okay. Uh-oh. Hacker. And now I am going to see about the stolen cat food.